Hello guys, how are you? So welcome to my channel IG Tech Team and also welcome to another video of deep learning. Now in this video, I am going to explain about face recognition system using deep learning. And I hope you have watched these three video so that it will easy for you to make understand about the concept using in this video. So let's get started. I have one folder in my desktop called face recognition system using deep learning. And let me open command prompt here and type Jupyter notebook, and let me make one Python file here. So new Python 3, and let me rename this page as FRS using deep learning. And first of all, we need to generate our dataset. So for generating our dataset, I will use OpenCV Python. So let me write here generating dataset. And for this, let me use OpenCV Python and hardcasket frontal face default as a classifier. And I have done this code a lot of time, so let me write very quickly here. So first of all, I need to import CV to, and to install this package, you need to write pip install OpenCV Python and press enter. And then let me make one function here, def generate dataset. And then I will use hardcasket frontal face classifier. So face classifier equals to cb2.cascadeClassifier, and I can get this classifier from you can go to my video description and you can find hardcasket frontal face default.xml. and after opening this, you need to go to this raw and then right click on this page and click on save as, and you need to save this XML file in the same folder where your Python file is located. So inside face recognition system using deep learning folder, I have to save hardcasket frontal face default.xml. so save, and I need to copy this file name and paste it over here. So hardcasket frontal face default.xml, and then I need to crop my face from my whole body part. So let me write one function, face cropped. I have to pass one image, and then I need to convert this image into grayscale image. So cb2.cbt color, I need to pass same image, and then I have method cb2.colorBgr2gray, and then I need to use one method called detect multiscale method. So I have face classifier, I have loaded it over here. So face classifier dot detect multiscale, and I need to pass this gray image. And I need to define scaling factor as suppose 1.3 and minimum naivers as suppose 5. So it identifies the coordinate around my face. So if faces is empty, let me return none. But if it finds my coordinate as x, y, w, h in faces, I have to crop my face. So CROPPED cropped face equals to, from my image, I need to crop from y to y plus h and x to x plus w. And guys, I have already explained this code in this video. So face recognition part 1, you can watch this video so that you can make clear understand about the code I have written here. So I have done this code already, and after curve my face I have to return this face. So return cropped face, and then I need to open my webcam. So cap equals to cb2 dot video capture 0 for internal camera and 1 for external camera. So you have to write 0 if you don't have your external camera, but let me write here 1. And I need to write image id equals to suppose 0, and I need to open one infinite loop while true rate and frame. So when I read this camera, it will return two value, rate and frame, return value and frame. So this is our image frame. And if face cropped frame is not none, then we need to increase image id. So I have passed this frame in this function, and if there are any image, then it will perform some operation here. I need to resize my face, so cb2.resize. I need to resize my face cropped frame into suppose 200 by 200, and then let me convert my image into grayscale image. cb2.cbtColor, I need to pass face here, and then cb2.colorBgr2gray, and I need to mention my path where my file is to be stored. So file name path equals to inside data folder, and let me concatenate this with plus sign, and authorized person name suppose Ishwar dot. I need to write image id, and I have to convert this image id into string, and then finally dot jpg. So inside this data folder I will save my image like iso.1.jpg, iso.2.jpg, iso.3.jpg, like this. So let me create one folder as data here. Let me create one folder data. If this function find my image, then it will increase my image id by 1, and it will assign to iso.1.jpg, iso.2.jpg, like this. And let me save my image cb2.imwrite. I will save my image in this path, file name path, and I need to save this face. So I need to save face in my this path, file name path, as name iso.1.jpg, iso.2.jpg, like this. And I need to write cb2.putText method to count my image. So putText inside face, and I need to write image id. So I need to print image id in my face, and this is the origin point where my this image id is to be written. So 50-50 is the origin point. And let me write one font method, so cb2.font or c. Let me write complex. We have several methods, complex, simplex, plain. So let me write complex here. And font scale is 1, and color is 0255 0, means green color, and 2 is thickness. And then I have to show my image, so cb2.imso cropped face. This is my title, so cropped face, and I need to display face. And then cb2.weight key 1 equals to equal 13. So 13 is the ask character enter. So if I press enter, then it should break from my infinite loop. So if I write 27, then if I press escape key, it should break from my infinite loop. But 13 is the ASCII character of enter. So if I press enter, then it will execute this code. So it will break from my infinite loop. If my image ID, I need to convert this image ID into int, integer value. So if my image ID equals to 1000. So if I collect 1000 image, then it should automatically go outside from my infinite loop. And then I need to release my camera, and I need to destroy all windows. And let me print one message: collecting samples is completed. So I have completed this code, and let me call this function. My function name is generate dataset. Let me call this function. Yani RAT is generate dataset. So I have loaded my classifier RCascade in front of its default, and I have covered my face, and I have opened my webcam. And if this function find my face, then it will save my image in this data folder. And if this function, or if I collect 1000 image, or if I press enter, then it will go outside from my infinite loop, and it will release my camera, and it will destroy my all window. And finally, it will print one message called collecting samples is completed. And guys, I have used this CB2 and RCascade front or face default for only generating dataset. I will not use OpenCV and RCascade front or face default again after this code. So let me execute this cell. Shift enter. It should start to recognize my face and crowd my face. So you can see here, it starts to crop my face, and it will save my image in my data folder, and it will collect for 1000 image. Let me press enter for now. Okay, collecting samples is completed. But you need to crop your 1000 faces. There is 1000 images of your face. And inside this data folder, your image will be saved as like iso.1, iso.2.3.4.5, like this. And it is for only one authorized user, so you have to collect about 2 or 3 authorized user, and you have to collect 1000 image of each authorized user. And I have already collected my image, so let me delete this. So let me copy my folder that I have already collected. Now if I open this folder, you can see here I have 3000 items, 1000 images of each person. So I have one user, user.1, user1.2. So I have user1, and I have collected 1000 image of each authorized user. So 1000 of first authorized user, and similar like this, 1000 of second authorized user. You can share 1000 image of second authorized user, and in the same way 1000 image of third authorized user. So I have total 3000 items or 3000 image, and I have 3 person. So you need to collect your dataset. You can either collect image of 2 person or 3 person, your choice. So you need to collect about 800,000, your choice. Means you have to generate your dataset. And for second authorized user, you have to change in only name. So suppose user2.1.jpg like this, user3.2.jpg like this. So you will change in only name. And this is the code from our previous video. So now let me write main code from here. So first is create label, and for this we need to install numpy as np. You can install this by pip install numpy. And then let me define my label as a function, and let me pass my image name is parameter. And then I need to extract my name. So let me write name equals to from image name dot split. I need to split by dot, and then let me get index of -3. So what is this? So this is my image, and if my image name is suppose .1.1.jpg, so this is my image name, and if I pass image name in this function, then it will split by dot. So it will split by this dot sign. So split, and this -3 means from backside. So this is 1, this is 2. Sorry, I have issue.1.jpg like this. I have issue.1.jpg in my folder. issue.1.jpg, issue.2.jpg like this in my folder. So I need to split by this dot sign. So dot and jpg. And this -3 means this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. So this is my name. So it will extract my name or authorized person name in this variable. So let me clear this. And now suppose if you have 2 person in your data set. So if you have 2 person in your data set, you need to write if name equals to, suppose this is the name of first user. You need to return it's a numpy array. So you need to write suppose 1, 0. So if your this is the name of your authorized user, first authorized user, and you need to return since you have 2 authorized person, so you need to write only 2 value here. So this is, this 1 means true and this 0 means false. So the position of this authorized user is first index, and if name equals to this is the authorized, this is the name of second authorized user, and you need to return np.array 0, 1. So this 0 means false, because index of 0 is the user of this user, and index of second, index of 1. So this is the index 0, this is index 1. So in index 1 user is this user. So you need to write 10 and 01. But if you have 3 person in your data set, then suppose if name equals to this is the name of first authorized user, you need to return np.array first index is true and second and third index is false. Like this, if name equals to suppose this is the authorized, this is the name of second authorized user, and you need to return np.array suppose 0 false, 1 and 0 also false. And then if name equals to this is the authorized user of, this is the name of third authorized user, then you need to return np.array first and second index is 0 and third index is 1. So you need to remember this point. And this name comes from your image name. So Ishwar, Manish, and Vijay. So you can extract your name from this line of code. And if your name is this, then you need to return in NumPy array. So this is for a two authorized user, 2% in our set. So I have 3% in my data set. So I need to write this line of code. So if name equals to this, then I need to return this num as my as in NumPy array, and is my if my name is this, and I need to return mean second index is true and then third index is true in last case. So let me execute this cell. Okay. So I have successfully created my label. Then I need to create data. So CRET create data. I need to convert this image into NumPy array. So I need to create data from this image. And for this, I need to import OS. And then from random, I need to import shuffle. And from TQDM, I need to import TQDM. I will explain this and the use of TQDM later. Also, I need CB2 and NumPy, but I don't need to install. I don't need to import again because I have already imported it over here and also over here. So let me execute this cell and let me create one function def my data. And let me create one empty list, and then for this image in TQDM os.list directory, and my folder name is data. So my folder name is data. I have image in data folder, and then this for image in this means each image. For each image in my this directory, and this TQDM means it will display processor box or processing box. I will show it later. And write path equals to os.path.join. I need to join this data folder with my each image, and my each image is img. And then I need to read my image and convert it into grayscale image. So I can write in this way also. So cb2.imread, I need to read this path, and then I need to convert imread imread grayscale. So this is the another method to convert my image into grayscale image. And also I need to resize my image. So image data equals to cb2.resize. I have a resize method, and I need to resize this image data and into suppose 50 by 50. Let me resize my image data into size 50 by 50, and then I need to append this image data in this empty list. So let me write data dot append. I need to append this image data in this empty list, but I have to convert this image data into NumPy array. So let me write np dot array. And also I need to append label, so I can get label from this code. So I need to pass this function over there, and I need to pass image name, and my image name is this img. So I need to call label function here. So my label, I need to pass my image. So this image, my label is my function. So my label is my function, and img is my each image. So I need to get my name from, or my NumPy array from this function. That means in this data, in this data list, I have my image in NumPy format, NumPy array format, and also this list contains my name in also NumPy array. This NumPy array 100010001, like this. And after this, I need to shuffle my data. SUFFLE shuffle data. And then finally, I have to return data. So what is this shuffle means? Shuffle means to change the position of my data, like this data to another position. Suppose I have data in like this 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, then after shuffling I will get like maybe 2 4 3 1, like this. So I need to change the position of my data. Okay, this is the complete code of my data. To create data I need to write this code, and finally let me execute this cell and let me call this function. So let me write data equals to my function name is my data. If I execute this cell, you can see here this is processing box, and this processing box comes from this TQDM. So if you write TQDM, then it will show you a processor box. You can see here this is very interesting or very nice to see the processing box, and this comes from TQDM. And for this I have already import from TQDM, import TQDM. And I have 3000 images in my data folder, so it will take a little bit time. And this is the code to create data, and I need to pass this data in my model. You can see here I have empty list, and I need to loop in my image in my data folder, and I need to join my data folder or data with my is image, and then I need to convert my image into grayscale image, and I need to resize my image, and after that I need to append my image data and my label into this empty list, and finally I have shuffled my data and I have returned my data. So this code is completed. Now I need to split my data into training and testing part. So for training I need to write train equals to data from beginning to, if you have 2 authorized person and if you have 2000 data set, you can write 1600. You can pass 1600 image as a training set and 400 image as a testing set. And if you have 3000 image, you can pass suppose 2400 image as a training part and 600 images testing part. You can pass from 20% to 30% of your image to testing part, and remaining suppose 70 to 80% part is training part. So from 0 to 2400 this is my training part, training image, and for testing data, so from 2400 to remaining part means up to 3000. So I have split my image into training and testing part. And then I need to convert my image into, or I need to reshape my image, and for this I can write x train equals to numpy array i0. So this is list compression for I in train. I hope you know about list comprehension. I need to reshape this, reshape reshape this by shape -1, 50, 50 and 1. So what is this? First of all, I have separated or I have splitted my data into training and testing part, and in training part I have a x part and also y part, and also in testing part I have x part and y part. Suppose we have y equals to mx plus c. In this case y is a dependent variable and x is independent variable, and after splitting my data I have x train in my 0 index and y train in my 1 index. So I need to pass 0 over here. For I in train, this train, I need to reshape my image. this is my x train. So I have x train in my 0 index and y train in my 1 index. So I need to pass this 0 and this is the least comprehension, and I need to receive this into minus 1 50 50 1. So what is this? So this 50 50 means, you can see here I have resized my image into 50 by 50, and this 1 means grayscale image, and this minus 1 means it automatically calculates the number of our image. So I have 2400 image in training part, so this minus 1 means 2400. Let me print this also. So print x train dot shape, and also I have y train. So this is my label, and I can write y 1 index for I in train. I don't need to reshape this into this size. And next I have yux text equals to np dot array, and similarly like above, so I 0 for I in now test dot reshape minus 1 50 50 1. So this 50 50 means our dimension of our image, and this 1 means grayscale image, and this minus 1 means 600 image. So we have 600 image in our testing part. And let me print this also. Print x test dot shape, and finally we have y test equals to, so this is in 1 index for I in test. Okay, if I execute this cell, you can see here this minus 1 means 2400 50 51, and this minus 1 means 600 50 51, and if you sum this 2400 plus 600, it will be 3000. It means you have NumPy array or your image in X train and your label or your name in Y train, like this. And so now let me create model. So creating the model, so this is very important topic, creating the model, important part in this face recognition system, creating the model. Now guys, we need to install TensorFlow HTF. And guys, we need to install TensorFlow 1.14 version. So pip install TensorFlow equals to 1.14 version, because we will use a TFLON here. So to execute TFLON, we need lower version of TensorFlow, like 1.14, and TFLON is not supported after this version of TensorFlow. So you need to install pip install TensorFlow 1.14. So make sure you have TensorFlow 1.14 version. If you install TensorFlow equals to suppose the 2.2 version, then you will get error like can't find model TensorFlow.contrib, like this. So you need to install TensorFlow 1.14 version. And after this, you need to import a TFLON, TFLON, and you need to write TensorFlow here, TensorFlow STF import TFLON, and then from TFLON dot layers dot conv, you need to import conv 2d, and then max polling pol poll 2d, and then also from TFLON dot layers dot core, you need to import input data, and then dropout, and then fully connected, and then from TFLON dot layers dot estimator, you need to import regression, GRESSION regression. and I hope you have watched my this video, convolutional neural network, how convolutional neural network works. So you need to first watch this video and then let me execute this cell. So it takes a little bit of time and it will give you some warning because we have installed or we have import a lower version of TensorFlow. And to install TFLon, I think it is pip install TFLon, or you can check in your Google. So it gives me a lot of error, not error, it is only warning. Okay. So there are a lot of warning, and if you execute this cell again, then your warning will get cleared. And if you want to remove this warning in the your first execution, means if you want to remove this red warning, not this side, only red warning, then you can write like import warnings, warnings warnings. You can write warnings dot filter warnings, and then you can write ignore. But let me comment this line of code, because if I execute this cell once again, then it will automatically clear this warning. So let me execute this cell once again. Okay. And to create my model, I have to first reset my graph, tf.reset, act reset, default default graph. Guys, you must watch this video, convolutional neural network, because I will not explain the concept of convolutional neural network in this video again. And I have to pass my input shape. So combinet means convolutional neural network, combinet equals to input data. I need to pass shape, the shape of my image is 50 by 50 50 by 50, and one is grayscale image. So this is my shape of each image, and then I need to pass combinet equals to convolutional neural 2D. So this is the first phase of how convolutional neural network works. I have already explained this, and I need to pass combinet and 32,5, and activation is ReLU. So this 32 is a filter, and this 5 means stride. So this 5 is stride, so that the filter will move 5 pixel or unit at a time. Let me write it here. So 32 filters and stride equals to 5, so that the filter will move 5 pixel or unit at a time. And this ReLU activation function means, I have explained in this video, activation function in neural network. So ReLU activation function simply replaces negative value to zero and do nothing with positive value. And then let me write combinet equals to I need to do polling now. So I will use max polling. We have several polling, like average polling, mean polling. I need to pass max poll 2D and combinet, and then 5. So this convolutional neural network, this convolution and this max polling and fully connected are the step of convolutional neural network, and I have already explained this how convolutional neural network works. And then in the same way, I need to write combnet equals to, now I need to repeat this line of code, comb2d, I need to pass combnet, and then let me use now 64 as a filter, and 5 as stride, and then activation equals to again ReLU, and then again combnet equals to max pole 2D, I need to pass combnet and again 5. Now let me copy this line of code, Control C, and let me paste here, Control B, again Control B, and again Control B, and let me change filter as here, suppose 132, sorry, 2 bell, and then here 64, okay, and then here suppose 32. So this is only filter, 32 filter, 64 filter, 2 bell filter, like this. And we can do max pooling and convolution layer several times. So I have used here, this is first time, second time, third time, fourth time, so like this. And I think if I pass here only 2 bell filter, it will get me either, or it will decrease my accuracy. So I need to pass suppose more value, suppose 128. And I need to remove this code, max pooling and comb2d, and again max pooling and comb2d. Okay, this is fine. Also here I need to remove this code. So I have used max pooling, convolution and max pooling layer several times. Now I need to use I need to pass this value in fully connected network. So let me write CONVNET combnet, or let me write it here. So combnet equals to fully connected, CONNECT, the fully connected, and I need to pass combnet here, and then so this is my 1024 layer, and then again activation equals to ReLU, and I have a dropout function in TFLN, so I can use a dropout function to prevent from overfitting. So let me use combnet equals to dropout combnet, I need to pass combnet, and the probability is about 0.8. So this dropout, it is a simple method to prevent neural network from overfitting. So this is my input layer, and let me make output layer. So for this I need to write combnet equals to fully connected, I need to pass combnet, and then if you have two authorized person, then you need to pass two here, and since I have 3 authorized person, I need to pass 3, because I have 3 authorized person, and this is my output layer. And let me pass activation as softmax, it is similar to sigmoid activation function, but let me pass activation as softmax, and I have already explained about softmax activation function in this video. Finally, I have to optimize my model, or I need to deal with loss value. So for this I need to write combnet equals to, I have a regression method, and I have already imported over here, so import regression, and then I need to pass combnet and optimizer, I need to use optimizer method, suppose Adam optimizer, and this Adam optimizer is used to update weights based on training data. And guys, this Adam stands for adaptive moment estimation, and it is a stochastic gradient descent method. Also I need to pass learning rate equals to suppose 0.001, and this learning rate is used in the training of neural networks, and this value ranges from 0 to 1. So guys, if our learning rate is too low, then the training data will progress very slowly, as we are making very tiny updates on the weights of our network. However, if our learning rate is too high, then it can cause huge changes to our weights. So I have passed 0.001 as learning rate, means it will change tiny updates, means very low updates in our weight. And I need to pass one loss function. Let me pass categorical, categorical categorical cross entropy. So this is a method of loss function to deal with loss function. I can use categorical cross entropy method. And then finally, I can write model equals to, so this is my model now, tflon, flon dot, I have a DNN method, and I have to pass coordinate here, and then tensor, board, tensor board, borbos. I need to pass tensor board borbos equals to, you can see here, if you pass 0, it is a loss and metric base speed, and if you pass 1, so loss, matrix and gradients, and if you pass 2 as tensor board borbos, then you can see here. And finally, if you pass a tensor board borbos as 3, then it is for base visualization. So let me pass, if I pass tensor board borbos as 3, then it will take more time. So let me pass tensor board borbos as 1 1, and then I need to fit my model. So model.fit, here I need to pass my x train and then y train, and then I need to pass number of epochs, epochs epochs equals to, suppose I can pass 10 10 15 20. So let me pass 2 bell is number of epoch, it's not epochs, it's epoch, number epoch. So this 2 bell means this model, or it will look our data set for 2 bell times, means if I define a number of epochs equals 2 bell, means it will analyze or it will visualize our data for 2 bell times, it will visualize our same data for 2 bell times. And then I need to pass validation set, validation set equals to, let me pass x test, test, and also y test, test test, and then show matrix, so matrix is equals to true, so it will show our performance of this model. And then I need to pass one run id, I can pass any name as run id, suppose FRS, so I can pass any name here. So this is completed. So let me explain this code once again. So this is the code to reset my graph, and this is the shape of my input data. And I can use convolution layer and max pooling several times. And this is the filter. Filter means I can choose some filter from my image. So I have taken 32 as filter, and 5 means start, means it will jump or it will filter 5 pixel or unit at a time. Means it will move by 5 units at a time. And activation equals to ReLU. I have used ReLU activation function several times here, and then we can perform convolution layer and max pooling several times. And then finally, this is my input layer, and this is for controlling our overfitting. And finally, I have to use another activation function in my output layer, so this is for the best performance. And since our since I have 3 authorized persons, so I need to pass 3. And this is for optimizing our model, and also updating our weights, and also to deal with loss function. And finally, we have DNN method to create our model. And finally, we need to pass our training and testing data, and also we need to define our epochs in this fit method. And guys, we can define this filter depending on our complexity of our project. Now, let me execute this cell. So, shift enter. Since I have defined a number of epoch equals 12, so it will analyze my dataset for 12 times. Now it takes a little bit more time. So you can see here, this is epoch number 1, and you can see here loss value and also accuracy. You can see here the accuracy is increasing or sometimes decreasing also. So you can define number of epoch depending on your complexity of your project. More number of epoch doesn't mean your accuracy will be high. So you can define either number epoch equals to 10, 15, 20, 12, your choice. But it doesn't mean that if your number of epoch is high, then your accuracy will be increased. It doesn't mean. So you have to define a number of epoch by analyzing the result of your model. So you can see here it is an epoch number 4 and your accuracy is nearly about 99%, and the loss is sometimes increasing or sometimes decreasing also. In the same way, in case of accuracy, so you can see here it is nearly 100%. It gets increasing sometimes and decreasing sometimes. So it goes for about 12 times. Now it is epoch number 6, and we have done nothing, but this is from the how convolutional neural network works. Means first of all we have to take our input shape of input size, and then we have to perform several operation, like several steps in convolutional neural network, like maximum pooling, convolution layer. And then we have to feed our data to fully connected network, and then we have dropped our model. So we have passed probability at 0.8 so that it deals with overfitting. And then finally this is our output value. Since this is three since we have defined here three output layer, means there are three output, means that may be for first user, second user and third user, because we have three authorized user. And this is the regression function, means we have to pass ADAM optimizer and learning rate and also loss function. And finally we have to create model, and we have fitted our model, and for this we have to pass our training and testing data, and also we have to define our number of epoch. So accuracy is nearly 99%, and my epoch is this is now 11. Okay, you can see here finally my accuracy is 1, means 100%, and the loss is 0. So this is very accurately predicted, my accuracy is high, 100%, nearly 100%, and my loss is 0%. So this is this model is very well designed. And now let's visualize the data and make prediction. So let me write title. Let's visualize the data and make prediction. So let's see if our model predict our image or not. So for this I need to make one function. First of all, let me make one folder in my directory. So guys, make one folder here, new folder, and you can set any name you like. Suppose images for visualization. Okay, now inside this you need to put some images of your authorized user, and to capture our image we have a code. So you need to run this cell again, and you need to change in this file name path. So here you need to write file name path equals to your images, your folder name is images for visualization, UALIZAT visualization, and images for visualization, okay. And then you have to append image id str image id plus .jpg plus .jpg. So you can collect about 20 images of each authorized user. So you have to collect 20 images of each authorized user by name. Suppose 1.jpg, 2.jpg, 3.jpg, like this. And guys, I have already collected my image, so let me paste over here. Okay, you can see. So my image is stored in like this, 1.jpg, 2.jpg, 3.jpg, 20 images of each authorized user. So 20 images of mine, and next 20 images of another authorized user, and next 20 images of third authorized user. So I have total 60 items here. And for this, you need to run this cell again. And after, and you need to store this image in images for visualization folder, 1.jpg, 2.jpg, like this. And after storing images for first authorized user, you need to change the image ID to suppose 20, because you have to collect next authorized user from 21 to 40, like this. And then for third authorized user, you need to write 41 here. So you need to run this cell for 3 times, and you need to change only image ID. And you need to collect your image 60 items. You need to collect your 60 image, 20 of each authorized user. If you have 2 authorized user, then you need to collect 40 items. And then similar like above, you can see here, similar like as this, I need to convert my image into NumPy array, and I need to append my image to NumPy array image to 1 MP delete. So let me do this. Let me create one function, def data for visualization. Visualization, you can add any function name you like, and then suppose v data, visualization data. So this is empty list. And then for image in tqdm, I need to write os.list directory, and my folder name is images for SUALIZATION visualization. And then I need to write path equals to os.path.join. I need to join my folder images for visualization to my each image, so img. And then I need to write image nom equals to I need to split my index or number, so img split by dot, and I need to write here zero index. So my image is saved as 1.jpg, 2.jpg, 3.jpg, like this. So image, I have to write, okay, image dot split by dot, so split by dot, and zero means this index. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is extracted in this image nom. And then I need to convert my image into grayscale image. So img data equals to cb2 dot, let me read my image, img read, okay, imread path. I need to pass this path, and cb2 dot img imread grayscale, l grayscale. And then I need to resize my image. So img data equals to cb2 dot resize, and then I need to pass same image data, and then size of 50 by 50. So this code is repeated just like as above. And then I need to append this image data into my mptl, so b data dot append, and numpy dot array. I need to convert image data into numpy array image data, and then I need to pass my image number. So image number only. In the above I have passed label, so you can see here I have passed my label, but I need to pass now image number here, image number. Now I need to shuffle my data, shuffle shuffle my b data, shuffle shuffle my b data, and then I need to return same b data. So let me execute this cell. Okay, now I need to call this function. So b data equals to my function name is data for UALIZATION visualization. Okay, I have 60 image total. Now I need to write code for visualizing the image and prediction of image. First of all, I have to import matplotlib.pyplot plot as plt. You need to install this package by p install matplotlib, and then I need to define my figure size. So plt dot figure size, let me define 20 by 20 as my figure size, and then for norm comma data in enumerate, and to pass my b data. Suppose I will predict my 20 image, randomly generate 20 image. I have shuffled my b data, so I will take any 20 image and I will predict that image. And then so this means slicing from 0 to 20 means 20 image, and I have already shuffled my data. And my image data is I can get image data from zero index of data, zero index of this data. So in one index there is my label, but I don't need any label. So I give my image data to my model, and my model predict my name. And I need to use a subplot method. So figure dot add subplot, 5 in row and column. So this 5 means 5 in row and 5 in column. And since I have defined I have to display 120 image, so 5 row in 5 column means 20 should be divided by 5, so that it gets executed. If you write here something like 7 or any other value, because 7 is not divided by 20 is not divided by 7, so it will get it will display error. But you need to write either 4 or 5, because 20 is divided by 4 or 5 or any other value. And you need to increase num by 1, so num plus 1. And my image is presented image data, so let me write here image equals to image data. And then I need to reshape my data. So image data dot reshape. Let me reshape this as 50 by 50, and one is my grayscale image. And then let me use my model. So model dot predict. I need to pass here my data in list, and I need to pass zero index. Let me write this code and I will explain to you, don't worry. Now if np dot argmax model out equals to 0, I will explain it to you, don't worry. So my level, I will assign my level equals to first authorized person name. Elif np dot argmax max model out equals to 1, then my level equals to second authorized person name, and else third authorized person name. So what is this? Since I have three authorized person, you can see here the main concept lies in this code. So I have three authorizer and I have assigned Ishwar to 100, Manish to 010 and Vijay to 001. This means 1 means 100%. So first index is Ishwar, second index is Manish and third index is Vijay. Now in this model out, so where is model out? So in this model out, the output will be like this. Suppose the 0 index will be 0.9 or 0.8 and 0.1 is second index and 0.1. So what does this mean? This means my model predict 80% image is Ishwar, 10% is Manish and 10% is Vijay. So which is maximum value? Of course 0.8 is maximum value and this index is 0. So if np dot arg max model out equals 0, means if this index 0 has maximum value, then my label equals to Ishwar. And in the same way, suppose if this is 0.2 and suppose 0.6 and suppose another 0.2, this means maximum value is 0.6 and this lies in second index, so index number 1. So if np dot arg max model equals equal to 1, it will print Manish. And in the same way, suppose if my model predict 0.1, 0.2, suppose 0 in the same way 0.8, so the sum of these values will be equal to 1, means 100%. Means my model predict 10% image is Ishwar, 20% is Manish and 80% is Vijay. Means index number 3 is 2, in index number 2 is highest, so it will print or it will assign Vijay to my label. So in this way model out works. Let me clear this. Now I need to show my image. So my figure subplot is located in Y, so I need to write Y dot imso. I need to show my image. So this is my image and I need to write cmap equals to, I will display gray image. And then let me put my title as my label. So this is my title. Authorized person name is title. And let me delete axis value. That is, let me write y dot axis dot get. This is x axis, and set visible. So I will not display x axis like 1, 2, 3, 4 value. So I will write false. In the same way, y dot axis dot get y axis. So axis dot set visible as false. And finally, I need to show my image. So plt dot show. Okay, this is my figure, size of my figure. So 20 by 20 is my figure size, and the enumerate means 1 by 1. So it will go my B data folder for my visualized data for 20 image, and then it will take my image and it will plot my image. I have reshaped my image to 50 by 50 size. And then my model predict my image. So model out equals to, it will return 3 value in a list. And if first index has highest value, then it is of course me as Ishwar. And if the index of second value is highest, then it will print Manish. And if the third index value is highest, then it will print Vijay. So I have displayed my image and my title of my image is my name. And I have invisible my y-axis and x-axis. So let me execute this cell. Shift enter. Okay, you can see here. So this is Vijay, it is correct. It is Ishwar correct. Manish, Ishwar, Manish, Ishwar, Manish, Ishwar, Vijay, it is also correct. Everything is correct. Okay, Ishwar, Vijay, Manish, Vijay. Okay. Every image is correct. So I have taken 20 image and my model predicted all images their name. So all of them are correct. So this is how you can use a TensorFlow and TFLoan to predict your image. and you can see here my accuracy is 100%, and I have predicted my new image. So I have generated my new image, and you can see here it will display very correctly. Not a single image is wrong here. So this is very well predicted model. So I have generated 60 images to visualize my data, and 3000 images for my training and testing of data. So this is how you can predict your image by using convolutional neural network or deep learning, or by using TensorFlow and TFLoon. So guys, how is this video? If you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. And do comment if you don't get understand. And you can find every project in my machine learning and data science playlist. So you can see here hand written digit recognition, face recognition, every project you can find in this playlist. So you can watch here. And guys, I hope I help you a lot in this video, and see you in the next video. Thank you.